Hello guys, welcome back to Innovative Design Tutorial. Today we are going to design a simple seating table in SolidWorks, and in this video I will tell you so many commands like how to use structural design member and how to use gusset features and trim and untrim command. So let's see how we create this simple seating table in SolidWorks. I hope you like it. Thanks for watching. So let's see how we create this one. So go to the file, now select new, and here select part option, and it will be save here. And now we open the SolidWorks interface, and here first do one thing, change this dimension to millimeter, centimeter gram, and make it plain white, background plain white. So here go to the features sketch, and select this one, and select 3D sketch. So we will create 3D sketch for this weldment feature. Now go to the top plane, right click, and select top plane, then normal, and here we select the center rectangle, and from this origin point make a center rectangle up to here. Now exit this sketch, and go to the smart dimension, select this horizontal line, and make it 1500 millimeter. Now select this line and make it 600, then OK. Now here drag this sketch, press with shift key, and simply select here. Now again go to the line, and from this point we make the vertical line, and make sure it is vertical and parallel to this axis. So simply select here, go to the smart dimension, and make it 600 mm, then OK. And here we select the line, make the line up to here, again exit, select make the line from all the four points, and make sure it is vertical to this and parallel to this axis. So then OK. And here do one thing, select this line and select all this line separately, and make the relation equal, so it's all the line will be 600 mm. So again select the line, and here we select from this point, and select this one, go to the smart dimension, from this point and this point the gap will be 150 mm. Again select the line, and here from this point make the line up to, if you not find this in direction, so we can use the tab feature. So select this point, then OK. So it parallel to this line, again select the line, and from this point make the line up to this point, and again select and meet this point, then OK. Now here we use weldment structural design, so exit this sketch. Now again go to the weldment feature, and select this one, and here we select the structural member, and go to this make the standard ISO, and select the type, so we can use a square tube, and here it will ask size, so we make it 30 into 30 into 2.6 So select this one, and here it will option group. So we select the group. So select this line, select this one, select separately all this connecting line, then again go to the select the new group, and here we select this line separately, this one, and select this one. Again go to the new group and select this line. And last one, this one, then okay. So here we create this. Sketch, so it will be done. And here we use the gusset feature. So select this gusset, and it will ask supporting faces. So if you want to create the gusset here, so the supporting faces one here and faces two. So simply select this face and this face. So it will create the gusset, and here it will ask the distance for this gusset. So I use 45, and this one also 45 length, then okay. So thickness, what about thickness? So I will use 5 mm. Here we can use according to your requirement. Suppose we use 8 mm, so it's bigger. So normally I use 5 mm, so it's come down, then okay. Now again go to the gusset and separately use all this corner. So select this face, this face, again select this one and this, and this last one. So select this face and this one. So here we use a gusset feature to this. So first of all, apply the material for this one. So go to the appearance, select the appearance, and here we select the material zinc, and make it we use matte zinc. So simply select, drag and comes here, select this body, and here we can change the color. So go to the appearance and select this one, double click on it, and make it black. Then okay. So we use polish steel here, and we apply the color later. So again select this face, gusset face, sketch, and make it normal. And here we create a hole for fitting upper part of this sitting table. So So select this circle, and here we find the center point, and simply select here and go to the smart dimension and make it 10.5 dia, and select this point and this line, and this gap make the gap 12, then okay. Now again select the center line and create horizontal and vertical center line here for mirror feature. So select this one, select this center line and make it here. Now go to the mirror command and simply select this circle and mirror about this center line, then okay. Now again go to the mirror feature and select both circle and mirror about this center line. So it will not, make sure it is not vertical. Select this one and make it horizontal. Now go to the mirror features, select this circle, both circle, and mirror about this horizontal line, so it will be mirror, then okay. Now here we make the extrude cut, so go to the features, now select extrude cut, and here we make the extrude cut up to 10 mm, so it will be cut. Then okay. Now here we cut this portion and now save it, this body. So if you want to apply the color, so go to the polish thing, double click on it and make it black, so it looks good. Now save it on file, so go to the file and make save as. Here we go to the desktop and select the new folder and make it as you require to name it. So now here we again the create the second part for this, so go to the file, now select new, here we select the assembly, then okay. Now go to the insert component and here we select the main body and drag here. So again we create the sitting table upper body here, so go to the insert component and here we select new part, so select new part and select this face, so from the on it face we create the new part and here we go to this normal. and make it. So go to the center rectangle and make the rectangle from this. Sorry, not center, we use corner rectangle. And select this one. Now exit this, escape, and go to the convert entities and now select this circle. So it's convert to a sketch. So separately select all this circle here, select this one. This one and this last, select this one, then OK. And here we apply the fillet of 3 mm all this edges. So select this one and make it 5 mm fillet. So simply you can use drag here, select this one and drag, so it will be selected automatically all this corner, then OK. So we apply the 5 mm fillet all this corner and exit this sketch. So here we use the extrude feature. So go to the features and select extrude boss base and here it will select up to this face. So go to the blind feature and select up to surface and select this upper surface. So it will extrude up to here according to this weldment, then OK. Now exit this sketch. So here we create the top part of this seating table. So if you want to apply the material for this one, so select this upper face part, select and go to the appearance, select this part, and here we apply the wooden. So select, go to this appearance and go to the organic folder, and here it will option go wood. So select this one and here we use rose wood. So select this one and here we apply this color. So it looks better, then OK. So we create this simple structure, and here we apply the nut and bolt for this fitment. So here we use a round bolt M10. So go to the design library, select this one and select this toolbox, and it will option we use ANSYS Maltray. So select and select this bolt and screw and go to the socket head screw, and here socket button screw. So select this one, simply select and drag up to this one, select this one, it will selected. and here it will use M10 and make this length. So drag and extrude up to 30 mm, then OK. Now again select all this hole, this one, this one, and the last one. Now here we apply the nut, M10 nut. So go to the design library and here we select the nut hex and select this one and simply select and drag. So it will selected M10, then OK. And simply select all this. Select this one. And this last, then OK. Now exit this sketch. So here we create the simple sitting table in SolidWorks by using weldment feature. So I hope you like it.